some years the apples won't ripen and they're not really a good flavor. This year, with the early sun, it shoved the apples along, and then we come along with the rains, and that made them grow, and the two together, they ripened up when they should have, and when they're ripe like that, they're, people like them. I think apple trees like mountain ground. You don't see orchards very often in the flatlands. The ground where the trees are used to be, you know, just the rocks and not worth very much. Pushed the rocks out and buried them. So kept each year planting a few trees to get a young orchard started and then take the old trees out. It was back in the 30s. Well, originally, my wife, she lived in this house when she was young. And she never got over a mile away from here her whole life. So when I come around here, I stayed here, you know, and helped and lived here and started to make cider. And then the place was put up for sale and we bought it. Well, when I first came here, it was a dirt road. It was mostly, you know, horse and wagon or just an occasional car. There was orchards on every farm, and every individual made 100 or 200 gallons of cider for their own use. At that time, they were more of the old varieties, Ballins, Greenings, Spies, Sheepnose, Russets, Starks, Pollywally. There's about a dozen varieties. There isn't any of them around anymore. Everybody had lots of time. Everybody had a good time. The people used to be more friendly, I think, more sociable friendly than they are now. They used to go to each other's house in the daytime and sit down, and they'd sit, they'd get a pitcher of cider, sit down and spend an hour or two and talk. In the daytime, no anymore, I don't think anyone does it. They just don't bother taking the time. They don't have the time or don't want to take the time. Everybody thinks they have to make money. And they spend all their time making money. As soon as they're not making money, they go out to spend that money. They don't take the time in between. Wife, she's up there all the time. She takes care of the stand. Sometimes I think it's too much. And when we have lots of vegetables and bring them into the truckload, she sells them all and tries to wait on people when I'm busy and helps me where she can. And it's a lot of running up and down, a lot of work. But so far, we've been able to get along pretty well the way it is. I hope it stays that way. Well, you bring the apples in, and most of them is run through a brush machine to fix the leaves out, brush the residue off. All the expense you put into apples, you couldn't put them all into cider. You'd have to get an awful price out of cider. So you sell the biggest ones and the nicest ones, and the small ones you put into cider. Well, the kind of work I have is so changeable. It's never the same from hour to hour, day to day, or week to week. And I think that way you can work day after day, 7 days a week, and not get tired of it. When you do things that way, it's easier to do them than if you get up and someone says, you got to pick every apple on that tree today. Well, that isn't the way I'd want to do it, maybe. Well, I use the Ford tractor to run the mill with. It takes quite a bit of power, and the tractor sits outside of the building, and I have about a 40-foot belt, and I have a power takeoff on the back of the tractor, which is a pulley wheel, and that runs the belt. The belt goes in on a large wheel, It all runs off of the same line shaft, which most of the farmers around had belts like that running off of tractors. They used to take the apples in boxes. They dump the apples in, they go in water, and the elevator picks them out of the water and takes them up to the top of the building inside. And they fall down into a, we call it a grinder. Each apple has thousands and millions of cells in it. Each cell has a cider in it. You grind an apple upright, you break the cells down. Now this press here, you can grind a bushel in a few seconds. And it grinds them up fine. And as they come down through the grinder, they come down through a chute. So you have, we call them claws, and you put two or three bushel in one of those, and it flattens it out, and then you fold that together. You've got to completely close it because it's like a fine applesauce, and the least little hole or opening that'll fly out when the pressure comes on it. So under it, you have a lattice rack that's got slats going both ways, and so that seals each claw shut or holds them shut when the pressure comes on it. And then it's on a cart and wheels, so you wheel it out from under the chute and you put it over on a platform like, and that platform has a hydraulic pump under it, and the press will start coming up under it, and it'll push it up under, and you set it so it just gets all the juice out, and that's all, and it works automatic. The cider that I make here, all I do is grind the apples, press it, let it run the barrel into the jug, so there's nothing put into it or nothing taken out, because the more the apples in, there's more the flavor is there, and that's what people want. They want cider. Now, to take this same cider, and the minute you get it made, you force it through a big filter, and it makes it look real nice, and you put it in a storm, and then they pasteurize it, which stops the fermentation, or they put some kind of chemical in it, but that's not cider, it's apple juice in. But mine is cider. Red Delicious and Golden Delicious, when they're ripe, mixed in, set cider off because they're a real sweet apple, and a mixture of three or four kinds with them makes the very best cider. But the main thing of making cider is it has to be a ripe apple. If you leave it set, immediately it'll start fermenting a little, and the longer it sets, the more it'll ferment and begins to get a sour taste. Still good drinking, but the longer it sets, it'll start picking up a certain amount of alcohol. And then if it sets a long while, it'll start going sour. And it becomes real sour. They call it vinegar, and vinegar is sour cider vinegar is real good vinegar. And vinegar is one of the mainstays that most people want today, and which they can't buy anywhere. There's very, very few people sells natural vinegar anymore. Most of the vinegar in your store is distilled vinegar. Distilled vinegar, distilled natural vinegar is cider just set and gone to vinegar. Well, I've made that way for over 40 years, and I get more customers each year. And if I changed, I'd lose all my customers. Thank you. think people like to come to the cider press because everybody that's coming here is interested in cider and apples, and they all have the same idea on their mind, and they're all friendly. Where any store or anything you go to anywhere else, everybody is pulling away from you, and nobody is friendly. I often think most of the people is friendly when they come, and they bring their families, and they make a day out of it, some of them, and I think some of them likes to wait. Each other, and they even help me a lot, and I charge them, and I don't wonder why, but I guess they're glad I do it, and I think people likes to help people, and they like to be occupied when they're at a place. They don't like to walk around the circles. They like to keep busy if possible, and lots of people that don't know each other help the other man think nothing of it. All squeezed out, we shove the cart over then to the other end, and then we have to empty all those claws out to make the next batch of cider. And that ground up apples in there is called a pumice, apple pumice. And sometimes you have the truck there, we dump it in the truck, and if the truck is busy, we just dump it on the ground and take the scoop when we're done and load it on the truck and take it down, and we dump it on a heap. When the pumice becomes dried out, it can be put on the ground, and it enriches the ground and loosens the ground up and makes the crops grow better. Some places where they have a lot of it, they dry it and they put it in the dairy feed for the cows. Some fellows, they pile up, maybe if there comes a deep snow, they claim up their camp, they'll feed the deer, keep them alive. Well, when you start to get the cider and then the pumice, and if you let go the humus after 3 or 4 years, spread it around, there's nothing wasted, there's nothing gone. It's all used up, and you start right back over again.
Lord, we thank you for the good health that all of our children have, and thank you for everything. Lord, help to bless this food to our body, and bless our bodies to your service. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. Good health, everyone.
Well, we had a son and a daughter, and they both was born and grew up here, and they both helped around the press, and they both got married, and they gave them both a piece of ground right next to us, and they both have a family, and the boy has 2 girls, and the girl has 3 boys and a girl. And when the cider press or the vegetables is gone, they usually are here all the time to help out, or they just like to be around the stand. People coming and going interest them. They like to wait on people. It doesn't make us too mad.
Am I supposed to open it?
Yes. Yeah. Oh, it came in the mail.
Oh boy, she's
going to have it out.
Retired.
My wife, she's often been babysitter, but some of them is getting bigger than babies now. But it's an exchange of help. I don't think anybody would ever frown on that kind of exchange of help, back and forward. Anything they want of mine, in the vegetables or fruit or cider and or anything they want to use, they can use, they know it. And you got somebody that you know will look out for you, look out for your things, and all of the family, the daughter and son and the grandchildren, they all seem to have a lot of interest, and as soon as we're busy, they just come around and give us a hand. Plant something and you see it grow and it grows good, you're willing to, I believe, take more interest in it, take care of it more and try to make it better. And you seem to have all we need. It seems that hardly a day goes by there isn't some of the grandchildren and they're there, and it's I think that's the way it should be. Families should be closer together.